So let's say we want to create a different template, but we want to have the same header and footer. What we gotta do is copy all of that, create a new file, upload it to MODX, and then every time we make changes to the header, we have to copy and paste the absolutely same changes to all the templates that need the same header and footer. Well, what if there is a better way? There is. We're going to use something called MODX Chunks. What MODX Chunks are, they are snippets. They're very similar to PHP includes if you're from PHP background. So instead of doing, you know, like something like this and saying include header.php, we're going to be doing something like this. Double square brackets, dollar sign, header, and that's it. Our header can get included, and then all the changes we make on one file will be transferable to all the files. So let's get started. The first thing I want you to do is let's go to our directory. All right. Now I want you to right click your button, mouse button, new folder, and I want you to write here chunks. Okay. It's important that you name your folder chunks so that future developers would know what they are. Now I want you to go inside and I want you to create another folder, and I'm going to name it template includes. Okay. And inside here, we're going to create our header and footer. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to my VS Code. I'm going to copy the header code and I'm going to copy it. Then I'm going to create Ctrl plus N, paste. Then I'm going to go Ctrl plus Shift plus S. Then go to chunks, template includes, and I'm going to name this header.html. There you go. And then what I'm going to do is go back to base for baby template, and the place where I needed the header to be, I'm just going to put double brackets, dollar sign, header. All right. Now we're not done because we haven't told MODX where that chunk file is. So we have our header here, but it won't show up. So what we want to do is go back to the manager. Then I want you to go to elements. And then I want you to go to chunks. And here we have the format folder, and this one was created automatically by extras. The extras will create folders in the chunks and snippets as well. So what we want to do is we want to create a new category. So I'm going to create a new category. I'm going to call it template includes, and I'm going to click save. What this is going to do is it's going to create a new category, but we're not seeing it yet because there are no chunks into it. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go to elements, chunks, and I'm going to click this plus icon. Then I'm going to name my chunk header. And in the description, I can say header of the site. Then I'm going to click is static. What this is going to say is it's going to say to the system, hey, we have a static document that we want to include. We don't want to add all the code inside the content area of the chunk. We want to include it externally. So make sure you click this, and then you have this input over here, static file. Then you click on this icon, and then you go to assets, template, chunks, and then template includes, and this is the header that we want to include. And then we click OK, and then we click save. All right. Okay, and you see all that code is generated here. Do not edit this code if your file is static, because we want to be editing the code on our local machine and then pushing it through SFTP. We don't want to edit anything here because every time we push it, it's going to override this, okay? So now that we have saved, now when you save, the cache automatically gets cleaned. Sometimes it doesn't, so always make sure you also clear the cache. And then what we want to do is actually test it out. Now let's go, okay, so one last thing. We want to add it into the category called template includes and then click save. Otherwise, your chunks folder will get really, really full with chunks and it will be difficult to find. It's a whole thing, trust me. Okay, so let's go to our site. We have the header here. Now let's test it out to see if it's showing. If I can just find my tab. All right, it's showing. And to test that it's really working, let's delete this header and test the site, Control plus F, and we don't have any header. That means everything is working. And you might be thinking, Stefany, how does MODX find the chunks if they're inside multiple directories? Well, every chunk must have a unique name. Okay, so make sure they have a unique name and MODX will always find them. You don't have to write out the entire directory structure. And this goes the same for our footer, okay? So we have the footer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy. Actually, I'm going to create, you know, some kind of code. I'm going to copy this. Then I'm going to press Control plus N, paste the code, Control plus Shift plus S. I'm going to go to Chunks, Template Includes, and I'm going to rename this to, footer.html, okay. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my manager, Elements, Chunks, and then since we already have chunks in our Template Includes directory, I can just click on it, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click on this template directories, and I'm going to create a new chunk here, which will automatically add the category, okay? And then I wanted to say footer, the name of the chunk is footer, and the description will be like footer of the site, and then is static, and then I'm going to go find and go to assets, template, chunks, template includes, footer, and then I'm going to press OK, save, okay. All right, everything seems fine, and we have the footer and the header in the template includes directory, which is so nice. And then what I'm going to do is go to base for baby website, and remember, double brackets, dollar sign, oops, we don't want a double header, we want a header and a footer, and then let's go back to our site, and let's refresh, and there you go. This is how you template in MODX. It is super easy, and all you need is just HTML files. And you can use chunks the same way. For example, if you have a contact form, you can upload it this way. If you have a newsletter that appears in a couple of places, for example, if you have a newsletter and you want it to appear in the footer and in your blog, just use chunks, do the exact same thing, just add it in a new category, and you're good to go.